Well, let me say, here's a second.
Merci.
Oh, man.
Oh, merci.
Tamam. Sağ ol.
Yeah, very fine, thank you. I'm very much surprised to find that so many people with music, you know, I was welcome.
World exposition in 2025 in Osaka. And last year we had the election to be elected at the site. So thank you very much for your cooperation in supporting by the Philippine government.
And we have also history with Japan, in Manila in particular. One of the initial Japanese settlers came here in Manila, and that's what we call Plaza de Lao. We put a monument there, reminding the next generation that this area where the first Japanese in the early times.
Maybe 200 or 300 years ago.
Yes.
At that time, our country was closed to foreign countries. Nevertheless, they came here and they lived here and they died here.
Because of my experience in Japan, we are now trying to copy one system. With regard to rehabilitating our roads. In Japan, I know this, when they try to asphalt a particular road, fix the road, they do it in night time. In the morning, Gemba night, finished. No more
construction.
So we tried that about a month ago. In one long stretch of the city, I asked the city engineer, I want to copy what the Japanese is doing so that we'll not disturb traffic during daytime. finish what we can finish during nighttime, and we stop work during daytime when we try to rehabilitate those. So I want you to get all necessary stocks of asphalt for an X number of length. Then we do it nighttime. You know, we did it. And it can be done. It can be duplicated. So we asphalted at about 10 p.m. 5 a.m. finish. The following morning, the people were surprised. While they are sleeping, the government is walking. So I told them, okay, let's try it better. Make it as a matter of policy, and we try to rehabilitate our roads to asphalt system. We do it in nighttime.
I said, Mr. Mayor, Mr. Moreno, very famous in Japan, just because you clean up the Manila city in a very short time. Just like some very famous mayor of New York city. Maybe Mother Pinata Good, and he been up in New York City.
Yes.
And the same thing has been done here in Manila. Good that you are very famous in Japan.
We're trying to duplicate what they have done in the 80s in New York. They call it the broken window concept. When New York is so chaotic, there's drugs, there's criminality, there's disorder, there's filth, there's so many obstruction, and so on and so forth. So what the mayor did then, he started with basic. Fix the broken window. So the same principle that we're trying to copy and duplicate in a different approach. We try to clean up the city. So that's the basic. That's why when I was asked many times, I always started, I have not done anything yet. We're just trying to clean up the city.
Yeah.
The basic job. Hopefully, with the help of our people, with their cooperation, we will continue that.
Yeah.
We've been doing that until that. As we speak, about 30 rooms are being addressed. As we speak, simultaneously, then we go to another road, simultaneously, then we go to another road, then we go back to the same 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, then we go back to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So it's a relentless effort. We're trying to make it a habit for us, including our facilities. And I told the members of the city government, if we are asking our people to clean up their frontage, their community, we should clean also our facilities. So our markets are being washed and cleaned at least 4 times a week. Our hospitals and their backyards and surrounding communities.
Well, to tell the truth, a few days ago I was in the Manila Golf Club. I was playing golf, and towards the ending of the playing golf, you know, I realized that so beautiful scenery in country. We can see a very good forest, you know, green, and behind that, there are the very tall buildings, so many tall buildings.
That's BGC.
Yeah. It's just...
Is that Shinjuku?
Yeah. No, much more than Shinjuku. Because that building may be more than 80 or almost 100 floors. In our case, in Tokyo, maybe 60 at most, I think. They're not so tall. They are come to see the, with green scenery, and you have a very excellent technology to build up such kind of building, it shows the future of the Philippines. Yeah, you are enjoying a very high rapid growth, maybe more than 6% per year.
Yes.
And nowadays, our economy is down 1%.
Well, we are grateful also to the national government, to the effort of every department, and that the presidency of President Rodrigo Roa Duterte, that we're winning the inflation. Because against our group with regard to inflation. So far, we're not only us, but I think other financial organization of the region certified in the growth of the country. And if we will have if we're going to be consistent, continue what we have started as a country. I think someday, somehow, we will have a better country.
For me, you know, even Manila is just like Hawaii Island, you know, much more attractive to us. That means, you know, the Manila is very close to Tokyo and Osaka, only 2 or 3 hours
away.
In case of Hawaii, it's 9 hours. Therefore, we have to cross the line of the day and night. It's that a burden to our travelers. In that sense, only 2 or 3 hours we can come here. And so far, we Japanese are very open and go to play golf, in my case, in Hawaii. But in the near future, we'll come here to play golf again.
And Minister, if I may share it to you, yesterday I just tasked the Department of Tourism of the City of Manila to come up with a program to train people academically, academically speaking, from one of our institutions, to train a group of people who will be our tourist guide, so that later on, if we are going to be successful with this plan, we just coordinate with embassies, embassies of the respective countries, and write them a letter that any John Doe's and Mary who will visit the city of Manila, if they want assistance, tour guide, they can, we as a city, our employee, can assist those tourists, so they don't have to deal with the uncertainty, because we wanted to really boost our tourism. We have a lot of story. I just mentioned you about the perceptors, Japanese perceptors in the city. Almost all the stories of the country happen, if not all, most happen in the city of Manila. So we have a lot to tell. So hopefully.
What's more, you have so many authority foods we have never tasted. I don't remember the name of the small fish. I ate it at lunch time in Gold Coast. Waku Waku.
Lapu-Lapu.
Lapu-Lapu.
Waku-Waku.
I don't know the name of that fish. It's a very delicious. Why don't you export the fish to us?
Lapu-Lapu.
Very tasty.
Especially when it is steamed.
Steamed.
Better. Steamed lapu-lapu. Fresh, then you steam it.
Is that in the sea or in the river?
Well, the sea. See. They also breed that lapu-lapu. It can be also in the culture.
Fantastic.
Thank you. So, anyway, Mr. Minister, do we have anything that we can have to share? Just press the button. You are always welcome. come back to Manila. We miss them. Don't stay in Metro Manila, stay in Manila. Because as far as I remember, before, Japanese are everywhere in Manila. Especially in the late 80s and early 90s. They love this day. So that's why I want them to hope they continue to trust the city government. And in our own little way, you tell them also that at the very least that we can guarantee no one will come. They can do business here fairly. As long as you treat our people fairly, you'll have an opportunity here in the city of Ogo.
I have one thing to ask you, as the mayor of the city. Our economy is suffering from the shortage of workers. For example, convenience shop used to be 24 hours working.
Yeah, I just read the Matsumoto case, the 7-Eleven case. I was reading it a while ago.
But now, you know, those shops have to close at 10 o'clock in the evening because of a shortage of human workers. And very recently, your government has held an examination to test the technology and the language ability of the Filipino. So I heard almost 1,000 people has passed that exam. Please, we are welcoming those people. Please come to Tokyo and Osaka as soon as possible. Please help us.
Okay. We'll coordinate with the OWA, right. POEA, and DOLE. We'll coordinate with them.
Last year, we have changed the system to take the foreign people come to the Japanese labor market. It became rather easier to get the qualification. However, so far, only a few people have come to Japan for working. We are going to change this tendency.
Yeah, you have a law.
My constituency is Osaka, city of Osaka, population 9 million people, and we have maybe 300,000 Filipino working in my prefecture. And they are enjoying working together with the Japanese people. I think we have so many foreigners who are working here. However, Filipino is the most favorable. And just as the Japanese people became a good friends and they form a family and they live, some people are here for a long time, almost like 50 or 60 years. Some of them have become Japanese people. So we are looking for some good workers who can work in Japan.
Okay. We'll try to look into it. We have a lot of skilled people here in Manila.
Yeah. Especially caregiver, the hotel workers, restaurant workers. Anyhow, I'm very happy to be welcomed by the national answer.
Thank you. That's our city bank.
That's the
We do that to members of the our VIP visitors.
Yeah, thank you.
Mr. Minister.
This is just a simple
post.
Please. But it's unique simply because he's the pictures.
Oh,
the city of Manila.
Uh-huh.
In the old times.
Uh-huh.
Thank you. All the houses of Manila.
Yeah.
Thank you. Hi. You
take
care.
Yeah.
I like doing you outside.
Put it to your friend, Mike.
Thank you.
What?